and welcome to the historic White Rock Baptist Church, located at 3400 Fayetteville Street in Durham, North Carolina, where the Reverend Dr. Reginald Van Stephens is the pastor. Thank you for giving us the opportunity today to bring God's house into your house. And so we are excited about what God has done for us and what He continues to do for us each and every day. So call a friend, text someone, tweet someone, and even talk to someone to tell them that there is a word from the Lord today. So let's worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. And we pray that you enjoy today's pre-recorded Worship of Christ service at the historic White Rock Baptist Church.
Come on and let's join in the worship. We've come to lift our hands. We've come to do our dance. We've come to sing our praises. Give God glory. Let's do this call and response. We come to lift our hands and give Him glory. We come to lift our hands and give Him praise. Sing with me. We come to lift our hands and give Him glory.
We come to lift our hands and give Him praise.
Come on, we come to lift our hands.
We come to lift our hands and give Him glory. We come to lift our hands and give Him praise.
Everybody sing.
Soprano.
Hallelujah.
Give him the praise. Give him the glory and the honor.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Good morning, White Rock. We are here this morning to praise the Lord, to glorify him, to worship him, and to lift him up. We're here for no other reason, not form nor fashion, but to glorify the Lord. We're here to lift up and exalt the name of Jesus. And as we do so, God, we welcome in your Holy Spirit. Welcome in your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. And serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. Yeah. It is not we that made us, not ourselves, but God made us. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. As we enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise, be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for your presence here this morning. We thank you, God, as we invite you into our worship service. For Father, you told us when two or three are gathered in your name, that you would be in the midst. We thank you, God, that you have given us a heart of praise, a heart of thanksgiving, and a heart of worship. We pray, O Lord, that we will open our hearts to receive your word, open our ears to hear your word, God. And we pray, O Heavenly Father, that we will open our eyes to experience your presence. We thank you this morning, Holy Spirit, for filling us with your joy, filling us with your peace, and filling us with your love. We thank you, God, that on this day, Lord, we're here to praise you and worship you. And Father, we pray, oh God, that if there's someone here today that doesn't know you for the free pardon of their sin through faith in Jesus Christ, God, that you will save, that you will convict and convert. And God, we just thank you and praise you. And Lord, we pray for our church family, Lord. We pray for our friends, oh Heavenly Father. We pray for those that are going through things, God. We don't have to name them and we don't have to call out the issues, God, because you already know. Father, we just thank you, Lord, that you are a comforter, that you are a healer to those that are going through health issues, God. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, that you correct finances, Lord, for those who are having trouble with their money, oh God. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, that you're mending broken relationships. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, that you are giving us wisdom and knowledge for your word. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, for strengthening us and keeping us. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, for guiding us through your word. We pray, Lord, for those, God, that may be having some health issues, God. We pray for your healing. We pray, oh, Heavenly Father, for our children. We pray, oh, Lord, as they go through the summer, Lord, that you will be with them, that you will guide them and protect them. We pray, oh, Lord, for our seniors, oh, God. We thank you, God, for seniors with good health, sound health, God. We thank you, oh, God, for healthy bodies and sound minds. We thank you, oh God, how you can clear up a confused mind and heal the sick bodies. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, that even though we may go through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil because you are with us. God, we thank you that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. God, we just thank you right now for this body of Christ, Lord. But not only this body, God, but every church door that's open proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you for your son, Jesus. I thank you that he died on the cross for my sin, oh God. And I thank you, Lord, that he's gone to prepare a place for us, that where he is, there we will be also. Father, I lift up my hand this morning and say, thank you, Jesus, for all you've done for me. And God, I just pray right now for our pastor and Lady Miriam, Lord, as they are continuing on their vacation. I pray, oh Lord, for her father, God, and for what she has been through. I thank you, oh God, for your comfort for her. I thank you, oh Heavenly Father, for keeping them. I thank you, oh God, for our pastor. God, I pray this morning that as we go through this service today, that you will be glorified in all that we do. I thank you, Lord, for this choir and for these musicians. singing to your glory and honor. Lord, I just pray to you in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Let us continue to glorify the Lord and praise him as we continue in worship with our choir.
It's worship time. Lead me, guide me.
Lead me.
Ask him to guide me.
Guide me
along the way.
Along the way.
Or if you lead me.
Or if you lead me. Be guide. Let us pray.
Lord, desire to lead me,
lead me,
guide me,
guide me,
along the way,
along the way.
For if you lead me, today. Come on, give us some praise. It's worship time. It's worship time. God is faithful. Says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Order my steps, God. Now that they do your will, be in your way, Lord. Bless the name of Jesus.
Thank God for that selection. Lead me. If the Lord's not leading me, I don't know who is. Amen. Now it's time for our scripture. We have two passages on this morning that we'll read. The first one is from Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31, the New King James Version. And the second one will be Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 through 7, the New King James Version as well. And they'll also be on your screen. The first one, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not faint. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The next passage, Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 through 7. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication. With thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Thank God for his word.
For all he's done for me, redeemed and set me free, and because, just because he's God. Can you relate to that? Can you thank God for all he's done? For all?
Oh,
Amen. So let the church say amen. Amen. Just because. Thank you, choir. Thank you, musicians, this morning. You have truly, truly touched our hearts, and we say thank you. To God be the glory. Yes. To God be the glory. I am, as you might discern, totally overwhelmed. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. I'm so glad to be in the house of the Lord this morning and to indeed to see you here this morning. Again, thank you, choir. Thank you, musicians. You have touched each of our hearts. Reverend Mitchell prayed a wonderful intercessory prayer that too touched my heart. And of course, Minister Norwood read our text for this morning's service and sermon, and I'm just grateful to both of them. Indeed, I am grateful to Pastor Stevens for allowing me to stand behind this sacred desk this morning. I am always humbled to do so. And God has been so good. Just before I came up, Deacon Ernest Jenkins gave me a note and asked for special prayer for Mother Alice Logan, who is 103 years old. What a blessing, what a long and wonderful life that she has had. And indeed, I have not spoken to her personally, but did speak to her daughter about a week ago, and Mother Alice Logan is now in hospice care. And so we do want to pray for her. Mother Logan had a fall about 2 weeks ago and broke her hip, and she's had been doing so very well before that. So let us bow in prayer for Mother Alice Logan, 103 years old. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for your blessings. We thank you, Lord, for the blessings of long life. For those in our midst, Lord, Mother Logan has been a longtime member and servant of the Lord here at the White Rock Baptist Church. And so this morning, Lord, we pray for her comfort. We pray, Lord, that she will know that you are with her. And we know, Lord, that you are surrounding her bed right now, for your promise that you would never leave us or forsake us. And so we stand on that word right now. Lord, we pray for Bonnie Logan, her daughter. We pray, Lord, that you give her comfort and peace today as she stands by her mother's bedside. We pray, Lord, that these two women and the whole family, Lord, will know that you are there. We thank you, Lord, for the life of Mother Alice Logan, Lord. And indeed, Lord, we just say thank you for her right now. Thank you, God, for the opportunity to pray. Thank you for her life. Thank you for the service that she provided to this church. And indeed, as your Christian servant, Lord, we thank you. We praise your holy name for her. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Minister Norwood has already read from Isaiah 40 and 31, and our primary focus scripture this morning is Philippians 4, 6 through 7. Our sermon title, Are You Prayed Up? Are You Prayed Up? May be an unfamiliar expression to many people, but especially to our younger listeners. When we were reminded last Sunday of our church anniversary, the term prayed up flooded into my mind, and I began to think that this term, prayed up, was perhaps a common expression for the men and women who founded the White Rock Baptist Church in Durham during a prayer meeting in 1866, for it was a time of difficulty and it was a scary time. And for me, this concept of being prayed up sparked memories of my grandmother, who had also lived in a difficult and scary time. Some years after the abolishment of slavery, and particularly in the turn of the century, grandmother Katie, now a widow, with six young children, fled from the cruelty of the Jim Crow era in pursuit of a better life. Jim Crow was a time of terrorism, intimidation, and violence that was rampant in the Deep South. Still, in the Midwest, where she settled, scarcity and hardship continued to plague her life, but I never heard Grandmother Katie complain. Instead, I heard her say often and simply and quietly, "I'm not worried, 'cause I'm all prayed up. I'm not worried, 'cause I'm all prayed up." This was her refrain, her cry, her strength. I'm all prayed up. And you ask, what does it mean to be prayed up? In our focus scripture, Philippians 4, 6 through 7, Paul defines prayed up this way: be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. And from the Amplified Bible, Colossians 4, verse 2, Paul shares a similar understanding: be persistent and devoted to prayer, being alert and focused in your prayer life with an attitude of thanksgiving. Now, I want you to be aware that Christian prayer is different from meditation and positive thinking presented in self-help books. Christian prayer is founded upon thanksgiving. And when Paul says, in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, he means thanksgiving for Christ, who laid down his life for you and for me and offers each one of us a right relationship with the Almighty God. And as you and I spend the next few minutes exploring the concept of being prayed up, I ask you to consider, am I, are you all prayed up? Difficult days and trying times, such it is in the world we live in today. Every day, the news reports more darkness and uncertainty. We are bombarded with reports of walls of stone, fences of hatred, and words that define and separate God's people and all people. Over the last 2.5 and 3 years, more and more I've heard people, including believers, cry out in disbelief about unthinkable events that have struck fear and anxiety in their hearts that gives way to feelings of being overwhelmed and powerless. I don't know what to do, people say. What am I going to do? I've even heard people say, I think I'm going to buy a gun. I don't know what to do. This is a world that is scary today. But God's word is filled with hope and promise of God's continued love, his help, and protection. Hear the words of Isaiah 40 and 31. And I say these again, they've already been read, but I love this scripture. But those who wait on the Lord, hear it again. Those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. In his words, the prophet Isaiah extends a great promise of hope and strength. How do we get this strength, you ask? First, Isaiah is talking about trusting God. He's talking about to expect, to look for, and hope in the Lord. Isaiah's talking about giving God all your worries and doubts and fears. He's talking about giving your broken hearts and your broken dreams to God, trusting that God will take them. Our God promises that those who trust and wait on him will gain new strength and renewed power. And because you trust him, you will rise up. You will rise up close to God like a strong eagle soaring toward the sun. Isn't that something to rejoice about? Oh, isn't that something to rejoice about? That God will lift you up above the clouds to the sun if you trust him. Similarly, in Paul's letter to the Philippians, in the 4th verse, chapter 4, Paul encourages the church to stand fast, to be of the same mind, and rejoice. I say it again, rejoice in the Lord always. Here is a man bound in prison, with certain death awaiting him. Paul wrote this letter while chained day and night to a prison guard. He had few friends in Rome, and he was a man with many enemies who were very vocal about it. Yet this letter resounds with a note of joy. Paul says, I know what can happen, but I will say it again, rejoice. For Christians, for you and for me, we can never lose joy. Why? Because we can never lose Christ. Christ will always be with us. We don't have to worry. But sometimes we forget. We forget the promises of God. We forget his never-ending faithfulness, his unfailing love. Sometimes we forget to draw close to him, and we forget to pray with consistency. Instead, we rely on our own strength. Oh, I got this one, Lord. I can do this, you say. We rely on our own limited understanding of life and people, and we forget that nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God. Now, is that something to shout about this morning? Nothing will ever separate us from the love of God. Sometimes we hide or even move away from God. We allow the rush, the push, and the pull of our lives to push God to the background. But even when we forget God's assurances and his promises, he remains with us. He never leaves us alone. Thanks be to God, though, a remnant of his word lingers deep in our souls. And when we remember him, he returns to us to renew our spirits. And in times like these, it is important to remember that each day, each moment is a gift from God. Each moment is a gift from God. You don't know what's going to happen. You just don't know. Our God has given us the gift of life, the gift of freedom, and the gift of choice. We can all choose our direction and our focus. We can choose to see God's handiwork in our lives, or we can allow our hearts and our minds to close out the Savior. We have that choice. But know this, the peace of God's own being, his own peace, he shares with us. And his peace will guard our emotions and our thoughts. We only need to draw near to him and hang on to his every word. How do you hang on to his word? Well, you read his word, number one, and you pray. You talk to him. Paul urges in verse 6, be anxious for nothing. Do not worry about anything. Know that Paul's words, be anxious for nothing, is a reminder that God is near to his people. He is near to you and to me. He is here to you right now, sitting in the pew. He is near to me right now, standing at this pulpit. He is near to you right now. Paul's statement reflects Jesus' own authority in Matthew 6 and 25. Therefore, I tell you, Jesus said, do not worry about your life. Do not worry what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes? Know that worry robs us of peace. To worry is to doubt God's ability to help. To worry is to ignore God's word. So Jesus turns to us and continues in verse 28 to 30 saying, trust God and don't worry. Now there may be greater sins than worry, but there is none more self-defeating or useless. Trusting in God is the best thing we can do when life gets hard. Have you ever had a hard time in your life? Have you ever not known what you were going to do? Have you ever, think about it, have you ever had a hard time in your life? I have. But God has always been there to direct, to lead, to answer, to show, to be. He's always been there. He is the only one that can offer true comfort in a time of need. Recently, a Christian woman asked her minister to pray for healing of a family member who was experiencing a serious health condition. The minister not only prayed for the health issue, but also that peace, tranquility, and trust would be restored to the requester. At the end of the minister's heartfelt prayer, the woman expressed her gratitude and then quickly added, "I still can't help worrying." The woman forgot that we have hope because we belong to Christ. The woman forgot that wonderful things happen when Christ displaces worry at the center of our lives. She forgot that our Lord is the quieter of our storms. And she forgot that we only need to trust Him and He will lighten your burdens and give you peace. She forgot. Prayer and trust in God. Excuse me for a minute. The woman forgot. Prayer and trust in God is our antidote to worry. Paul also stresses in verse 6 that we can take everything to God in prayer. Everything, but in everything, he says, in prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. In everything, Paul is telling us that there is nothing that we should leave out of our prayers. Our God is concerned about our every care. There is nothing, no nothing too great for Him. In prayer, we can praise Him and give thanksgiving. We can say, "Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for helping me. Thank you, God, for saving me. Thank you, God, for lifting me up this morning off my sick bed. Thank you, God, for all that you do in my life. Thank you, God, for saving my kids. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for my church family. Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, for you are good." In everything, thank the Lord. We can also bring our supplications. What are supplications? Our pleas, our requests to God. God wants us to come to Him and to ask for what we need and what we desire. Lord, I need you today. Lord, I need you behind this pulpit today. Lord, I need you as I sit here in this pew. Lord, I need you when I walk out the door today. Lord, I need your help. I don't know what to do. Lord, I need you right now. Oh, I need you. Jesus said, "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you." Jesus made the way for us to come boldly to our Father and ask for healing, for provision, for that job you need, for peace, for freedom from addiction, whatever it is. It might be sweets, who knows what it is, but He can release you from that addiction. You may ask the Lord for joy. You may ask Him for patience. Oh, I've heard so many people say, "Oh, I don't have any patience." But God puts that spirit of patience inside of us. And all we need to do is ask Him. Ask Him to perfect it for us. God is patient with us. Why can't we be patient with Him? Why can't we wait on the Lord and be sure? Why don't we have patience? You can ask God to cure your spouse, your child. We can ask for forgiveness of our past sins. No matter what it is, God will forgive you. All you need to do is ask for forgiveness and ask him to give you the strength to carry on. James 1:5 says, if you lack wisdom, ask him. Amen. Oh, we can pray for others. Ask God to help people you know to live for God. For we know that empty of Christ, a heart stands vulnerable to darkness. James 4:2 reminds us that many of our prayers go unanswered because we do not ask God for what we want. But God invites us to let our requests be made known to him. He wants to know. He's laid it out there in his word. Tell me everything. 1 Peter 5:7 tells us, cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Getting through difficult times may not always be easy, but God has given us his word to make sure we understand his promises. Jesus said in Matthew 21:22, if you believe, you will receive whatever you ask in prayer. So when we call upon his name in prayer, he encourages us with his presence and fills us with his Holy Spirit. Have you ever prayed to the Lord? I have. And before you could finish the prayer, it's already done. It's already done. He answers when you trust and believe in him. When we call upon his name, he encourages us, and his presence is with us. And then he says, and be thankful. Be thankful. Paul reminds us of thanksgiving. Our thanks must always be a big part of our time with the Lord. Sometimes you just go to the Lord and you don't ask for a thing. You just thank him for where God has brought you from. You just thank him. Thank you, God, for allowing me to be who you made me to be. Thank you, Lord, for the gifts and talents you have given me. Thank you, Lord, for bread on the table. Thank you, Lord, for a place to sleep. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for those who love and care for me. Thank you, Lord. Give thanks in everything, in sorrows and joys alike. Give thanks. Give thanks and tell God you appreciate what you have, that you appreciate who you are and what he has given to you. Most of all, thank the Lord for sending Jesus to pay for my sin on the cross. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for saving me. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, I love you. Thank you, God, that I'm not what I used to be. Thank you, Jesus. Paul says in verse 7, and when you pray, God will establish peace in your hearts. God will put that peace in your heart every time. Oh, I see you smiling because you know it's true. God will put peace in your heart. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Paul's heartfelt guidance assures us that the peace of God's own being, which he shares with us, will guard our emotions and our thoughts. I don't know about you, but I need a guard. I need a guard. In the Greek, The word guard is much stronger than our English language. The Greek definition suggests that this peace guards our hearts like a squadron of soldiers guarding a town. Can't you see it? Don't you see the picture? It's like a squadron, a bunch of guards, a bunch of soldiers guarding our hearts. And the peace of God is beyond our understanding. Know that mankind can never produce it. It is only God's giving. It is only God's giving. You can't beat God's giving. You just can't beat it. And the way of peace, and the way to peace, is in prayer and holding on to God's unchanging hand. Empty of Christ, a heart stands vulnerable to darkness. So I ask you to think about it. Are you prayed up? To be prayed up requires intentionality about your prayer life. You've got to be intentional and set aside time to pray unto the Lord. Set aside a special time daily to pray. Just don't wait till something happens. Pray to God every day. Thank Him. If you got nothing to ask the Lord for, just say, thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Read His word. Pray His word back to Him. Lean on the Father throughout the day for guidance, for wisdom and strength. To be prayed up is to yield your heart to God. To be prayed up is to talk with God without ceasing. It is to trust and believe God hears your every prayer and trust that He will answer. To be prayed up is to believe that the Lord lightens your burdens and draws you closer to Him. To be prayed up is to turn your focus from what's wrong in your situation to find something you can be thankful for. To be prayed up is to look to Him, the one who works all things together for your good. To be prayed up is to trust that God will act in your situation and quiet your storms. To be prayed up is to gain the power and strength from the Lord that keeps your mind and your heart open to Him. To be prayed up is to secure your heart with God's grace and seal it with praises to Him. To be prayed up is to hear God's voice in the wee hours of the morning. Say, don't worry, I am with you. I will never leave you. To be prayed up is to cast all your anxieties on Him because you know that He cares for you. To be prayed up is to trust Him more. And I leave you with this. Make prayer a habit. And tell God what you want. Keep your heart and emotions focused on Him. Choose to embrace the evidence of God's goodness in your life, in your church, in this church, and in those around you. Thank Him for the light that shatters the darkness. Allow prayer to govern your life and secure your heart with God's grace and seal it with praise for Him. Allow God to displace worry and guard your heart. The opportunity is yours. The opportunity is yours today. Choose the sun's bright rays over the storm and rejoice in the Lord. Trust Him. Trust him. Wait on him. Do it all in thanksgiving. And ask yourself, am I prayed up? Am I prayed up? To God be the glory. Oh, God is so good, and he is in his holy place today. God is with us today, and he will answer every prayer. Several years ago, when I first came to White Rock, Pastor Stephen said he wanted the White Rock Baptist Church to be a praying church. And don't you know that if all of us, every single person, would gather in this place and raise the roof in prayer, oh, how happy and glorified our God would be. Oh, God is good, and his mercy endures forever. If there is anyone here today that is without a church home, won't you come? The doors of this church are open, and we invite you to join this membership, to join with these wonderful Christian people and share your joy, your life together. The doors of this church are always open, and so at any time, you are always welcome. Whether you are here in the church this morning, or whether you're listening by live stream, the door remains open to you. God is good, and he is waiting for you. To God be the glory. Amen.
That are here for you. If you're listening via the internet, you can bring your tithes to the church office. You can call and have someone come and pick them up. You can pay through your financial institution or PayPal or Givelify. But we ask you right now to be obedient to what God has called us to do. So at this time, I'm going to pray for our offering, and then we're going to ask you to rise and come forward and put your offering in the basket set out for you. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to bow right now, Lord, and say thank you. We thank you for your powerful word, God, a reminder, Lord, that we need to be in constant prayer. Father, we just thank you, oh God, for your blessings. Father, how you have blessed us so marvelously, Lord, and we just thank you for the opportunity to give back to your kingdom. God, we just ask that you bless us, bless our offering, oh God, that it may be used for the building of your kingdom, God, and to help others, Lord, so that we can be a blessing to someone else. God, we just thank you. We thank you for every gift, and we thank you for every giver. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. You can now come.
Joining the White Rock Baptist Church's pre-recorded worship of Christ service today. Please join us next Sunday and invite your friends and families to join us as well. May God continue to bless each and every one of you.